So just checked in on my flight to the Philippines, and it went extremely smooth here at Vancouver International YVR. It went so smooth. I thought it was going to take a lot longer than it did. There was talk on the news that there was lineups that took hours. Well, it was actually very easy. I got my COVID test. They sent it to me in about half an hour, and then after that, I filled out the One Health pass, and everything went very smooth. And checked in, everything was great. Getting on the flight, Philippine Airlines direct to Manila, then catching my layover, catching the next flight to Cebu, and then ferry to Bohol. So it's going to be a lot of traveling, and then a van ride to the house. Only place that's open is Subway, and that is the lineup. No thanks. I've been waiting in line pretty much all evening, and the last thing I want to do is wait in another line. I'll eat on the plane, although here's Starbucks, and that was looking a little more acceptable. Interesting thing is, I'm on a Philippine Airlines flight to Manila, and I'm the only white dude here. Everybody else is either Filipino or Chinese or Indian or whatever. There's actually one other foreign guy, and the funny thing is, I know him from a few years ago, and he looked at me funny, I looked at him funny, and I'm gonna go say hi once he gets, he's eating at Subway right now. I saw him with his girlfriend, so once he gets here, I'll go and say hi and see if he remembers me. But isn't that funny, small world. But yeah, this is 100, I'd say 99% Filipino on here. And last time I was on this flight, there were a lot of foreign guys. I look tired and fed up. It's because I am. Things were going okay until I got out of the airport in Cebu. And after that, the wheels kind of fell off. And it's a miracle I'm even here at the ferry terminal. Basically what happened is I got a cab. Everything was fine. The guy didn't rip me off or anything. I gave him a good tip, but he didn't rip me off. He didn't even try to rip me off. But he dropped me at the ticket office for the MV Starcraft ferry to Bigan, Bohol. And so he lets me out. I pay him. I walk with my luggage and a small luggage. And next thing you know, the ticket office is closed. And I'm in not a very good part of the town with my tooth bagged. And I asked a local, I said, where else can I get tickets for to Bigan, Bohol? And she said, walk down to Pier 2, it's about a 10 minute walk. So at this point I got my luggage, so I get a trike, it's actually a trike, it's not a motorbike, it's the guy's riding the bike, trike. And He takes me to another ticket office. I get inside and there's a huge lineup. And half an hour later, I finally get my ticket, get back on his tricycle. He takes me back to the Pier 3, which is where I am now. And it wasn't too bad until the boarding comes for our ferry and they announce it's delayed at least an hour. So here I am, it's been a long day, and yeah, I guess it could have been worse, but things went very smooth at the airport in Vancouver. There was a long lineup, but that's to be expected. Other than that, it went smooth. The flight was fine. The Manila Airport. It was a little bit of a shit show, but it could have been worse again. Like, as long as you got your QR code for the One Health, you got the QR code, then you are good to go. If you don't have that QR code, then they're gonna herd you like cattle into this big room, and they're gonna have to manually check your vaccine passport and your antigen test or your PCR test, and you're gonna have to randomly check all that. So that's the thing. Like, you know, if you're gonna make sure you get the QR code, that's all I gotta say. Make your life a lot easier. So my day of travel, it's really 2 days of travel. It's consisted of, you know, a COVID test at the Vancouver airport, a super long lineup to check in, a 13 and a half hour flight, then a flight to Cebu, or first of all, 3 hour wait, then a flight to Cebu, then a long cab ride in traffic, heavy traffic, then a bit of a mishap I was talking about with the ticketing office and all that, and now a delay at the ferry terminal, and then at least an hour long ferry to Tubigon. Then from Tubigon, it's another hour and a half in a van or a bus. It's crazy. It's gonna be the longest day of travel in my life. So we're here on the ferry, and finally got moving. And I should be in Tubigon in 1 hour. Sitting in the business class. Business class. Bigger seats, high back seats. Really nice. Oh, look at that. That's what they call a jump boat.